Hi, I'm Laura McCabe, and I'm here to talk to you about thread. So here's the deal with beading thread. It's a little bit like politics or religion and shouldn't be discussed in polite company, I guess. It seems to be very controversial. So I have my own opinions, other people have their opinions, so I thought what I'd do is just come here today and tell you what I use, why I use it, and leave the rest up to you. There are a bunch of different options out there on the market. The one that I tend towards is Fireline. It is a fishing line, actually. It's produced by Berkeley, and it comes in different weights and two colors primarily. There's a smoke, which is sort of a gray, that's what I have here, and there's a crystal that's a white color. It comes, like I said, different weights. I tend towards the 6 pound weight. It's just sort of the right thickness for what I do. I need something that's small enough to make multiple passes through the size 15 beads I use, but you want something that's strong enough that it's going to hold up well. So I found 6 is pretty good. Occasionally I drop down to 4 if I'm working with gemstones that have really small holes in them. So with the Fireline, if you haven't used it before, you will discover very quickly that the smoke has oil on it. And because it has oil on it, it will get your hands dirty and you'll get everything dirty. So if you're using the smoke Fireline, you probably want to run it through like a paper towel or a tissue a couple of times before you use it. That will take some of the oil off. I was excited recently to discover the Fireline Microice, which is actually, it's a little bit different than the regular Fireline. This is made for ice fishing, and I don't know why, because I don't ice fish, but the smoke version of this has way less oil on it than the regular Fireline. So it's a lot cleaner to work with. So the only thing is, I've only ever been able to find it right on Berkeley's website. I've never been able to find it at a bead store, and in fact, I haven't even seen it at a fishing store. So I'm gonna put a link in the show notes for you guys so that you can see where you can get this microice. But it's a nice thing, especially if you work with a lot of smoke. There are also great colors available. There's a company now that's making colored Fireline. So again, in the show notes, there will be a link to that company so you can see, but they have a lot of great colors. So the advantage with Fireline that I have found in my years of working with it is that it's relatively stiff compared to some of the other threads. For me, that's good because I do a lot of geometric work, so it really kind of maintains its shape a little bit better than some of the softer ones. I don't like a lot of stretch on my thread, but there's just a little bit of give with Fireline, so it's just enough. If I have to tweak it a little bit, I can. The other thing I found is it holds up very well to crystal, which is very sharp, so I've had much better luck with the Fireline than with the nylon threads when it comes to the crystal. So, and that depends all on how you use your crystal in your work as well. But for me, that has been my experience. The other thing that I tell people, which horrifies everybody when I tell them, but I do actually wash my beadwork on a regular basis. So when I'm done with it, I find, you know, from the wax, using the wax that I use, it leaves fingerprints and whatnot all over it. So I just run it under some warm water and then pat it dry with a paper towel. I don't use any soap or any cleaning products on it. I just use warm water and I run it under there real quickly and then dry it off. But of course, you would want it to be a fishing line if you're gonna do something like that. You wouldn't wanna do that with a nylon thread. So that's another real advantage for the Fireline that I found over time. If you wanna be daring and do like me and wash your work, I tell people just try it on a small piece of beadwork before you go ahead and do it, because I've never had problems, but I do know of people who have issues because of, you know, minerals in their well water or chemicals that are in the city water or whatever it is. So you don't wanna do, like, put your big piece in there and ruin it right away and then be mad at me because I told you to do it. So if you're gonna do it, try it out on a smaller piece to begin with. So Fireline 2, one thing I can say is over the years I've found it's held up really well. So I've been using it since 2003 and I have not had problems with it degrading or deteriorating or breaking or anything like that in my work. So, you know, it's hard to say what's going to happen in 100 years, but in 17 years, so far, so good, and I've been really happy with it. I have, unfortunately, had nylon thread rot on me, which is something that can happen over time. It was sort of my earlier work that dates to the late 90s, really. I did that all with Nymo. That was the thread that I used at the time. That was kind of the thread that was out there. And I have had a number of pieces that over the years have, it has actually like disintegrated and it's like beads are falling off and whatnot, which is a shame. So, but Fireline, so far, so good. Like I said, it's been 17 years. We'll see what happens. Now, now that I've said all that about Fireline, I have some other things to say to you about thread. There are a lot of nylon threads, which a lot of people love the nylon threads. The nylon threads are, they're good, they're more flexible, they're more like a thread, where Fireline is a little bit stiffer, so if you're not used to working with it, it might be awkward for you at first. But the nylon threads are good. I personally only use them when I'm stitching leather and the thread is exposed, if that makes sense. So I have a bracelet on here today. When I stitch the edge here, the edge of it has, it's been whip stitched with thread and it has little beads on with each stitch. And for that, I did use a nylon thread. I actually used C-lon. C-lon's a great thread here. It comes in like lots and lots of awesome colors. So I will put a link in the show notes to C-lon too, because that is a nice thread. So, but for me, I really only use it when it's sort of exposed and showing and to match my leather. I don't really use it in any of my beadwork. There's also 1G, which is also a great nylon thread. And for me, I only use it, like I said, you know, when I'm stitching in a way that the thread is exposed and you're gonna see it. But a lot of people really like 1G. And I think 1G, it's quite good. I found that it doesn't fray or wear where the needle is the way that Nymo does. So, and I'd say the same thing about C-lon. I find that they hold up better than Nymo because that was my original experience, was using Nymo. So all of my threads I will wax with microcrystalline wax. I like using the microcrystalline. People have different opinions about this. I like it because it really can sort of, it conditions your thread, it keeps knots to a minimum, and it really helps with tension. And the reason I think it does is because it is so sticky. If you think about it, when you pull your thread through, you pull it through, it kind of grips everything and it holds it rather than have it retract a little bit. So if you're having an issue with tension that's too loose, you may want to try microcrystalline. It is a synthetic wax. It's sometimes you'll find it sold as synthetic beeswax as well. It's not always listed as microcrystalline, but it's one of the things that's great about it for me, because as I said, I wash my work. It has a very low melting point, much lower than beeswax. So it doesn't take a lot of heat in your water if you want to wash it off. It's great. It's great in that regard. It also, it's very stable. It's actually used by archaeologists in labs to preserve objects. So it is, it's a very stable material. Whereas beeswax, not that anybody cares, but over like 100 years, it can go rancid because it's an organic material. So if you're worried about the future of your beadwork, this is a good choice as well because of the stability of it. The other thing I can say about it is it's an excellent hair product. When you're in a pinch, you need a wax. It's very good for doing your hair as well. So that's why I like the wax. So I use that anytime I use thread. So even if I'm sewing clothing, I use microcrystalline wax on my threads. So that's kind of about what I have to say to you about thread. There's a lot of other ones out there. There's, you know, tons and tons of the different nylon ones that are made by different companies. So, and to be honest, I haven't used them enough to have an opinion, so I'm not going to tell you what to do about those. And in fact, I'm not going to tell you what to do, because everybody has their own feelings about thread and what they want to use. And it really depends on the type of work you do as well. Certain thread lends itself to certain types of work. So hopefully that was useful information. Be well, stay safe, and bead on.